When preserving food, it is important to know how spoilage and disease-causing microbes grow, survive, and multiply. Knowing how to stop the growth of these microbes ensures a safe and tasty preserved product. I am Megan Baumler, recording for Suzanne Dreesen, University of Minnesota Extension Food Safety Educator. In this How Microbes Grow and Survive presentation, I will review the six factors that affect the growth and survival of microbes and explain how food preservation methods stop microbial growth. Microbes are like us. They need specific conditions to grow. FATTOM is an acronym used to remember these six conditions that spoilage and disease microorganisms need to grow and survive. Just think of Tom the turkey. His six feathers represent these conditions. Microbes need food, a perfect acidity level, time to grow in the perfect temperature range, oxygen, some organisms need oxygen while others survive without it, and finally, moisture. Pluck a feather, remove one of the conditions to break the chain and to stop bacterial growth. Let's look at each of these factors. Just like us, microbes need an energy or food source to grow and survive. Protein and carbohydrates are good sources. Mold is feeding off of this tomato and growing and thriving. A is for acidity. pH is an index of acidity. Values on the pH scale range from 0 to 14. The lower its value, the higher the acidity. Low acid food with a pH higher than 4.6 needs to be pressure canned to destroy Clostridium botulinum spores so that they will not grow and produce the deadly toxin. Looking at the chart, we see that vinegar has a pH of 3.0 and green beans have a pH of 5.6. If we pickle the green beans and add a vinegar solution, we will bring the pH below 4.6 and can safely process them using the boiling water bath method. The first T is for temperature. Bacteria grows in the temperature range of 40 to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. This is called the temperature danger zone. Move food through this temperature danger zone as quickly as possible during the preservation process to keep the bacteria from growing. Let's look at food preservation methods to keep food out of the temperature danger zone of 40 to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. We will start at the top of the chart. 240 to 250 degrees Fahrenheit is the temperature range that a pressure canner will reach at 10 to 15 pounds of pressure. These temperatures will inactivate enzymes, destroy heat-resistant spores like Clostridium botulinum. 212 degrees Fahrenheit is the temperature reached when using a boiling water canner. Boiling water temperatures destroy spoilage microorganisms like yeast and molds and heat-sensitive bacteria like Salmonella. 95 degrees Fahrenheit is the maximum storage temperature for home and commercially canned food. The best storage temperature for canned food is 50 to 70 degrees Fahrenheit. 32 to 40 degrees Fahrenheit are refrigeration temperatures to slow the growth of bacteria, yeast, and mold. Negative 10 to 32 degrees Fahrenheit are freezing temperatures to stop the growth of microorganisms, but some survive and can grow again once the food is back in the temperature danger zone. This is why thawing food in the refrigerator is so important. 0 to negative 10 degrees Fahrenheit is the temperature range for frozen food. If you can easily scoop ice cream that you just took out of your freezer is too warm. The second T is for time. Bacteria needs time to grow. It takes 2 to 4 hours for microbes when held in the temperature danger zone. After it's adapted to the environment, microorganisms grow, divide, and multiply every 20 minutes in temperatures of 40 to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. Let's say we start with one cell of bacteria. In 20 minutes, that cell grows and divides into 2 cells. In 1 hour, it has divided and multiplied into 8 cells. After 2 hours, that one cell divided and multiplied into 64 cells. One cell might not make you sick, but 64 could. The dose makes the poison. Some bacteria need oxygen to grow, but with Clostridium botulinum, it will only grow, germinate, and produce its deadly toxin in an air-free environment, which is exactly the condition we create when canning food. It only takes 3 to 4 days in the temperature danger zone to produce the botulism toxin in this environment. All life needs water to grow. In food preservation, we control moisture by drying to remove moisture or by adding sugar in jam and jelly to tie up the moisture so it's not available for the bacteria. Here is an example of how FATTOM can produce Clostridium botulinum toxin in a garlic-flavored oil mixture. The food is the carbohydrate from the garlic cloves, which gives the Clostridium botulinum energy to survive. ACIDITY, the pH range of garlic, is 5.3 to 6.3, which is above 4.6, and the perfect acidity for growth of Clostridium botulinum. For temperature, it's at room temperature, which is 70 degrees, which is exactly in the temperature danger zone. For time, the garlic oil mixture stored at room temperature for more than 3 days will allow enough Clostridium botulinum to grow, germinate, and produce the deadly toxin. Oxygen. Oil attaches to garlic and produces an air-free condition, which is needed for the growth of Clostridium botulinum. For moisture, garlic has available water for Clostridium botulinum to use for growth. Put these conditions all together and we have the perfect conditions for Clostridium botulinum to thrive and survive. Follow research-tested food preservation recipes and methods to stop the growth of microbes and to prevent illness. This is just as important for safety as for the taste of the preserved food. Preserving your own food has many tasty benefits. Knowing how to stop the growth of microbes is the first step to a safe and tasty preserved product. Thank you for listening.